You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Linder, your host. This is a special edition of Greater Brockton. It is dealing with the City of Brockton preliminary election. And I have here with me a familiar face to Brockton, John Drzinskas, who's running for Ward 6 Councilor. John, welcome. Nice to see you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me on.
You're welcome.
Good to see you. Yeah.
Glad to have you on. We're 2 years later. We're in Ward 6. And there are three candidates all over again, except there's a difference. There's a new candidate who we will also have on.
Right.
But John, 2 years ago, Jack Lally got elected the city councilor in Ward 6.
In Ward 6, that's correct.
Steve Foote was in the race. He went into the final.
Yes.
And Jack was victorious. He became the councilor. You're challenging him again. Steve is not, and there's a new challenger. Why are you doing it again, John?
Well, as you said, in 2015, I ran and I lost by a very small margin,
mm-hmm.
41 votes, I believe, that knocked me out of the preliminary election. So I'm back again. I think I bring a lot more than either one of my opponents to the table. I'm a retired retail store manager. Okay, I'm a lifelong Brockton resident. I've been involved with the community already, so I consider being a ward counselor a extension of my volunteerism. I do think I bring a lot more to the table than either Jack or Joanne.
Okay.
Which is the two opponents. You mentioned a preliminary election. I just want to say that to the people out there, it's very important that we will vote in a preliminary election. A lot of people think a preliminary or a primary is not important. It certainly is, because if you like me as a candidate and I don't get beyond the first election, November 7th is not going to happen. So the question is kind of moot.
You have the dates right here.
Yes,
on your flyer.
Yes, I do.
You're right. Brockton has had as low as a 4% voter turnout back a few years ago.
Which is sad.
It's pathetic.
Yes.
You're going to be nice about it because you're a candidate. I'm going to be.
Right.
I'm a journalist, so I'm going to say it's pathetic.
We want
people to come out. Presidential elections have the most turnout. Gubernatorial elections second. You get to the local level. Me personally, I think the local people are more important than the president and the governor.
Absolutely.
Okay. And city councilor, it's day to day. You get calls for, you know, potholes, snow removal, dog complaints, you name it, you get the calls if you're a ward counselor.
Yeah, going door to door, I tell people, I don't even mention November 7th. I tell them the Brockton's election is September 19th.
Right.
That's the important date. They need to get out there and vote that day. I don't even mention the general election, although it's mentioned on my cards.
It's just there as a reminder.
Everybody
that does these cards, if they're smart, they put both dates on
because they always
want to hope that they get past the first date.
Of course.
They're good bookmarks at the end of the
exactly,
day.
Exactly.
So John, you have on your sign right there, vote for real change.
Yep.
Okay. The last time you ran, the incumbent councilor, Michelle Dubois, was not running for re-election. So
right.
There were three people that were running for an open seat. There's a current counselor. What do you mean by real change? What do you mean by that?
Real change, I think the people of Ward 6 right now are being shortchanged with the representation they're getting from Councilor Lally. I give him all the credit in the world for being a young man and getting involved in politics. But I've often said you need two things before you dabble in a sideline like politics. And number one is the life experience, which I have, and he does not. How can you discuss a $400 million budget and property taxes and water taxes, water bills, when you yourself don't pay them? I'm a lifelong, lifelong resident of Ward 6, the village section of Ward 6. I'm a longtime homeowner. I've gone through the whole package. And the second thing is community involvement. I have involvement with a lot of community groups, civic groups, religious groups. And those two things, I think, separate me from either Jack or Joanne.
Now, John, I noticed that sometimes candidates run for office, and when they don't win, they go away. They disappear. They kind of evaporate.
Not my style.
You've stayed incredibly involved the last 2 years. You've stayed involved in the ward with going to Council Lally's ward meetings.
Right.
You've still been involved with all your civic organizations. I'm just going to ask this kind of facetiously. Are you glutton for punishment?
No.
Okay.
I being retired and having a little bit more free time than people that are working full time or students that are full time, like Councilor Lally, I have time to put back into the community, and I enjoy doing it. I enjoy volunteering for several different groups. I actually got more involved after 2015 instead of less. I didn't go mope someplace because I lost. I got more involved.
So let me ask you this. Issues in Ward 6. Big deal recently, there was a meeting that Council Lally held about the sports complex.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you and I both know sports complex has been talked about for years.
Right.
Now, all of a sudden, it looks like it's actually going to happen.
Right.
What's your take on that whole thing and how it's going to affect the residents? And do you support it? Do you think it's a good idea? What are your thoughts?
I think it's a good idea. I think it's a what I call a family-friendly business. It's a business that is good for the kids. Yes, it will be private. It'll be pay as you play, but it's something the entire family can participate in. I definitely support it as long as the abutting neighbors support it. And it seemed that the developer at that meeting you referred to answered most of the residents' concerns and questions about things like increased traffic, lighting, noise, and all of that. So mm-hmm. I'm definitely in support of that. And we need more businesses in Brockton, but more family-friendly businesses. A power plant and a casino are not family-friendly businesses. As you might know, I oppose both.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we don't know. What's the latest on the power plant? We haven't heard a
we
little
don't,
bit in a while.
We don't.
Casino seems to be pretty dead.
Yeah.
Let me ask you, you mentioned the village. You live right in the village. You're about as close as you can get. You're in it. You can take a pinpoint and put your house there.
Small side street, Faxon Street. Yeah.
It's dead. It used to be thriving. You remember the day when there were bakeries, there
sure.
were restaurants, there were bars, there
sure.
were different things. There's overgrowth, overbrush. It looks awful.
Yes. Yeah.
What would you do to reinvigorate it and to get it back on track?
Well, it's starting to make a little bit of a comeback, at least cosmetically.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot more single family homes being built. The old Franklin School that was vacant for several years is now gone, and there are some nice looking affordable single family homes there. As far as attracting new businesses, that's a tough question. Okay, we have a person that owns a breakfast cafe in Campello, buying the old what was referred to as the Lit or the Glass House,
and, yeah.
a problem bar we had there, but there hasn't been any activity either inside or outside of that establishment for going on 3 years. So as a counselor, you know, there's not much I can do to influence the owner there, but I would find out what the problem is, whether it's a financing problem, a permitting problem, because I'd like to have something in that building rather than another vacant building. So that's some of my plans.
You've been out there, you've been walking the ward, everybody goes out, drops these off,
yep.
tries to get signs placed. I got the 5-minute cue. So what major issues do you see that are out there, and what would you do differently if you got elected and the incumbent didn't get reelected?
By far, the number one issue in Ward 6, especially in the Brookfield sections, is the same as it was in 2015, and that is the roads, the infrastructure, the roads, and to a lesser degree, the street lighting. So, you know, I've heard that a lot of roads, especially in the Brookfield and Ashfield sections, are not recognized by the city. Well, that may or may not be true. If it's true, it's the sitting councilor's job to get that process moving forward. And that's something I would promise to do. It may take years, but at least get I understand there's a certain amount of roads or a certain amount of linear footage that councilor is allowed to fix per year, but you know, you at least have to have that process moving forward. So, you know, those people are paying property taxes too, and that's the number one issue in the entire ward.
I want to leave you time to make sure you get a closing statement,
sure.
But I do have one question. Counselor's job is not schools, but counselor votes on the budget that the school department is and works with their school committee member
right.
who's in Ward 6, and that's a race too. There are three in that race.
Yep.
How important is it to keep the schools in Ward 6 open? The Ashfield school's been talked about. It's been on the chopping block multiple times. What's your quick take on that?
My quick take on that is the Ashfield and actually both schools have to stay open. If you close a school, you have to move the students somewhere else, okay? And that always has negative implications. It may increase the classroom size, for example. And children develop relationships and friendships with other children, and if you break that up, then it ends up not being a good thing. So we definitely have to keep the schools open.
Before I forget and you do your closing, you might have it in there anyway. Phone number, website, Facebook, just tell them, and
sure.
then you can go right into your closing, and,
sure.
and you get about 2 minutes.
So my name's John Drzinskis, and I'm running for Ward 6 counselor. I think we need a lot better representation than we're getting currently or have been getting for the past 2 years. My phone number is area code 508-586-8599, and if email is more convenient, it's johnd27@verizon.net. I'm working on a website right now. It's currently a work in progress. I will have it up in another couple of weeks. I do have a Facebook page. You just Google John Drzinskis, it'll take you right to the page. It's mostly about my political campaign. I do think I bring a lot more to the table than either one of my opponents, and I respectfully ask for the people of Ward 6 to consider me on September 19th and hopefully November 7th.
There you go.
Yeah.
John, thanks for coming on. We'll have you back and
okay.
hopefully do a debate with the three candidates.
Excellent. Excellent.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you for having me on, Mark.
Glad
I appreciate
to.
It.
Glad to.
Yeah.
You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. We will have more candidates throughout the election leading into the preliminary City of Brockton election on September 19th. Stay tuned and watch BCA channels 912 and 98. Thanks for watching.